Hi, this is Gary. On today's episode, let's take a look at different ways you can perform calculations on your Mac. The most common way to perform calculations on your Mac is to use the Calculator app. You can find it in the Applications folder, or you can get to it through Launchpad or a Spotlight menu search. I've put it in my dock right here so I can get to it very easily. And you can perform simple calculations here, just like that. You can also do more complex things like switch to Scientific or Programmer Calculator, or stick with the basic one. Now, an even quicker way to do calculations is to use the Spotlight menu. In addition to searching for something here, you can simply type in some numbers. And you can see I can add two numbers here very easily. You can even do complex things by using parentheses, making this more useful in some cases than the calculator app itself. Now, you probably have the three iWork apps. And of course, Numbers is the one you would expect to be able to do calculations, and you can. Matter of fact, sometimes it's handy just to open up a spreadsheet temporarily to perform calculations. Like you can just put some numbers in here and then type in a simple formula. Get a quick sum. You don't even have to use multiple cells. I could just, for instance, in this cell here, type equals and then put in a formula like that and get an answer. But it is handy to do this because you can then change something and see how it affects the outcome. But it also is great to be able to use these formulas. You can do really complex things like using parentheses or using different functions like sine, cosine, square root, that kind of thing to get quick calculations. And there's no harm in just using this to do some quick calculations and then just quitting and not saving the results if you just wanted simply to get an answer. Now, what you may not know is that you can perform calculations inside of both Pages and Keynote as well. Just while you're in here, just create a table inside your document. And again, this can be something you just do temporarily. And in these, you can actually do formulas just like you could have done in Numbers, like that, to get an answer. Or typed in a couple of digits like this, 4 plus 6. And I'll just do a little formula here. And I've got a little mini spreadsheet. So you can definitely perform these quick calculations and then just delete this when you're no longer using it. Another option is, of course, to use the calculator in Dashboard. If you go to Dashboard, by default you have this little calculator here and you can perform really basic calculations in it. And you can also go and add other Dashboard widgets, and if you go search for more widgets you'll find that there's all sorts of different types of calculators you can use. Now, the terminal gives you access to some great command line tools. One of those is BC for Basic Calculator. And you can do basic calculations in it, but you can also do more complex things like that. So there's all sorts of stuff you can do with it. If you quit out of it and look at the manual for BC, you'll come up with all sorts of different information about different things that you can do in it. You can actually perform calculations lots of different ways in the terminal. For instance, another one you can do is you can run Ruby, and once you're in the interpretive Ruby environment you can type formulas there as well. And if you know Ruby you can actually use the Ruby programming language to do more things with numbers. Now, you can also use your browser to perform calculations. There are two different ways to do this. One isn't actually using your browser. It's actually going to use Google to do it, because if you have Google as your default search engine you can type in an equation like this and Google will not only give you the answer but then bring up a calculator that you can use here. So you can do fairly complex things and send them off to Google and it will give you the answer. And then you can play around with the calculator afterwards. The other way you can perform calculations is to use the programming language built into your browser, JavaScript. And you can get to an interpreter for that where you can type in commands. First you need this develop menu here. The way to get that is to go into Safari Preferences. Make sure under Advanced you have Show Develop Menu in Menu Bar. Then go into that develop menu here and bring up one of the tools like, say, the Web Inspector. And you're not going to actually use that. You're going to use the console here. Click on Console, and when you do that you get this little command line here at the bottom. And in the command line you can type in JavaScript commands. And these commands can be as simple as just a simple math equation like that, or something more complex. and it will give you the answer. You can also, just like with the terminal using BC, you can use the up arrow to go back. You can see I can go back through the previous equations and edit them. So I can do times 5 and then the up arrow times 6, that kind of thing. So there are a whole bunch of different ways I could think of to perform calculations on your Mac without having to install anything special. If you can think of some more clever ways to perform calculations, leave those solutions in the comments to this video at MacMost.com. We'll be right back.